Yet another very exciting week at CAS with the launch of the CAS Business Press, our very own publishing title with Palgrave Macmillan. The first book is by Peter Grant, Senior Fellow in Philanthropy, Grantmaking and Social Investment. Peter is with me now. Peter, tell me about your book.
Okay, it's called The Business of Giving, subtitle The Theory and Practice of Philanthropy, Grantmaking and Social Investment. So it's stems from my lectures on my master's programme in that subject, but it's not a textbook. It's aimed much more at the general reader. It's certainly suitable for all students that are interested in how philanthropy works, and anybody that's working in the philanthropic or grant-making field or is thinking of moving into that area. But I think it's also a more general book for readers that are interested in how this phenomenon of philanthropy actually works, and particularly how you go about the process of giving away money.
So you told me a little about who might buy it, but I guess the question is, why would they buy it?
Well, I think one of the real problems in philanthropy is that once people have decided what they want to fund, they don't think enough about the processes whereby they do that. And so that leads to a lot of wasted money and a lot of wasted resources and poor grant making. I'll take a couple of instances. Very often, people want to change the world with their philanthropy, but they don't actually have the resources to do that. And if you do a simple calculation before you start about what the impact is that you're trying to achieve, and then what resources that you've got to do that, you can see whether or not you're likely to have any significant impact on the area that you're funding. A good example, I think, recently was the NSPCC's campaign to eradicate cruelty to children. Now, the current chief executive at the NSPCC has reversed that policy, basically because the NSPCC, despite being a very large charity, simply doesn't have the resources to achieve that goal. And he instead is going to focus the charity on changing policy rather than eradicating the child cruelty at source. And then if you look at another area, a lot of funders don't think enough about thinking through from the impact that they want to make to exactly how you go about the process of giving that money away. Who do you want to give it to? How should it be given? Should it be money or should it be resources? Do you want to fund organisational development or sharp end activity? So what the book does, as well as being an overview of the current status and situation of philanthropy, looking at different philanthropic styles, the major part of the book, the third part of the book, actually gives you a blueprint for how to do it.
And this is the first publication of the CAS Business Press, our very own publishing title with Palgrave Macmillan. Tell me about that.
We've signed up a deal with Palgrave Macmillan, who I would say are probably our leading academic publishers in this country. It's coming out under the imprint of the CAS Business Press, and probably, somewhat unusually, I suppose, the first publication is one about charity and philanthropy. And I think that's probably a very good thing, and it positions CAS very much, I think, at the forefront of business schools, particularly looking at ethical dilemmas in business. Because in the end, a lot of the people that are going to be doing this are our top business leaders. And this is one of the things that they should be thinking about. How can they use their money for the betterment of society?
And before you go, I have to ask you about your T-shirt, the Ragged Trousered Philanthropists. What's the story?
Yes, it was a book published in 1911 by Robert Tressel. The title is somewhat ironic. It refers to the working class house painters in Hastings that he was talking about, and saying that they were actually the main contributors to philanthropy because they were working for starvation wages for the rich capitalists. And it has a resonance with my book, where I start off by talking about early pioneers of philanthropy like Andrew Carnegie, who believed that he should give away the whole of his wealth during his lifetime. And what he said, and I think is absolutely relevant today, is that with great wealth comes great social responsibility. And it's something which many of our business leaders should take greater note of. For example, recently there was a poll in this country that asked our 30 richest people whether or not they felt that they had a social responsibility that came with their wealth. And as far as I know, only two answered positively. One of them was Richard Branson. The other was an alumni of this business school, Stelios.
Peter Grant, thank you very much.